Hello everyone. Let us begin today's session. I am Alicia Ponce, founder and principal of AP Monarch, and my team will serve as a facilitator and translator of tonight's presentation of the plan for a new park, field house, and administrative office building at 48th and Western. Before we begin the presentation, I would like to review some general information about the virtual meeting. To make sure that you receive all future communications about the project from the Chicago Park District, please be sure to fill out the virtual sign-in sheet. You will see the link in the chat box periodically throughout the meeting. A question and answer session will be hosted during the second half of the meeting, wherein the project team will respond to questions and comments submitted in advance of the meeting, as well as questions and comments submitted live at this evening. Please note that if you are viewing this presentation over the live stream on YouTube or the project website, you will not be able to submit questions live. However, we invite you to submit any questions or comments using the virtual sign-in sheet. If you're viewing the live stream of the questions or comments, the presentation, you can find the link to the sign-in sheet in the project description text box. The Chicago Park District will acknowledge all questions and comments received during this meeting in a follow-up communication that will be available on our website sometime next week. As an acknowledgement of the wonderful diversity of this community, this session will be conducted in both English and Spanish. The presentation is being recorded and will be posted publicly to our project website later this week. The team has much to share. To start the meeting, I would like to introduce Heather Gleason, Director of Planning and Construction for the Chicago Park District, to welcome participants. Then we will provide an overview of this evening's agenda. Hola y muy buenas tardes. Vamos a comenzar la sesión de hoy. Yo me llamo Alicia Ponce, fundadora y directora de la firma AP Monarch. Mi equipo apoyará el proyecto como coordinadores e intérpretes durante esta sesión del plan para un parque nuevo, una casa de parque y oficinas centrales ubicadas en la esquina de la calle 48 y la avenida Western. Antes de comenzar, quiero revisar alguna información general sobre la plataforma virtual que usaremos esta tarde. Para asegurar que reciban toda la futura comunicación del proyecto del Distrito de Parque de Chicago, por favor rellenen la forma virtual. La forma se encuentra en el link del chat durante la presentación. La sesión de preguntas y respuestas será disponible durante la segunda parte de la presentación. El equipo estará dando respuestas de las preguntas que ya hemos recibido en avance de esta sesión. Y estaremos tomando sus preguntas en vivo. Es importante notar que si están viendo esta presentación por YouTube o el sitio web del proyecto, no podrán enviar preguntas a través de estas plataformas. Sin embargo, los invitamos a enviar sus preguntas o comentarios usando el registro virtual. Si están viendo la presentación en vivo por Microsoft Teams, el registro se encuentra en el link del chat. El Distrito de Parque de Chicago reconocerá todas las preguntas durante esta sesión y serán grabadas y documentadas en nuestra página web durante la próxima semana. Ya que sabemos que esta comunidad cuenta con gran diversidad cultural, la sesión será llevada a cabo en inglés y en español y será grabada y disponible en la página de internet del proyecto esta semana. Nuestro equipo tiene mucho por compartir. Para empezar la reunión, me gustaría presentar a Heather Gleason, directora de la División de Planeación y Construcción del Distrito de Parques de Chicago, quien les dará la bienvenida. Después, compartiremos un resumen del programa de hoy.
Hello, my name is Heather Gleason, and on behalf of the Chicago Park District, I'd like to welcome you and thank you for joining us tonight to learn more about Park 596. I'd also like to thank Alderman Burke, Alderman Lopez, the Brighton Park Neighborhood Council, and the Back of the Yard Council for all of their input and guidance to date. The continued support of neighbors and local leadership has helped our team develop an exciting vision for this park. Today, we are pleased to share our plans and hear questions and comments from the greater community.
Hola, yo soy Heather Gleason y de parte del Distrito de Parques de Chicago, les doy una bienvenida y las gracias por estar con nosotros por conocer más acerca del Parque 596. Me gustaría agradecer también al concejal Burke, concejal López, al Consejo de la Comunidad de Brighton Park y al Consejo de Back of the Yards por las ideas y comentarios brindados. El apoyo continuo de los vecinos y líderes locales han ayudado a desarrollar una visión emocionante para este parque. Hoy estamos aquí para compartir con todos ustedes la información más reciente de este proyecto y escuchar sus preguntas y comentarios.
And now, we're pleased to have Alderman Burke with us this evening, and I believe that the Alderman would like to say a few words. Alderman, please go ahead.
Good evening. Buenos tardes. I'm Ed Burke, the Alderman of the 14th Ward. Yo soy el concejal de Distrito 14. I'm delighted that the Park District, under the very able leadership of Mike Kelly, has decided to move ahead with this important project for the community. I was present at the groundbreaking a number of months ago, and the support of the members of the community and neighborhood organizations was important, I believe, in demonstrating the broad-based support for what will become an important part of this neighborhood. The planning that went into this, I think, was remarkable. It incorporated not only a building for the administration of the Chicago Park District, but also included the provision of a park, which is greatly needed in this neighborhood, and gives employment to many people, not only in the construction phase, but in the opportunities that will exist here when the administration building is up and running. To think that the transportation access that this site provides is a tribute to the people that have gone before us who were so active in planning for the Orange Line, which is immediately adjacent to this site. People that work at this site from all over will have access to the site, not only on the rapid transit, but will have Western Avenue, Archer Avenue, 51st Street as main thoroughfares to access the site. To say that this is a remarkable change for a vacant site that has languished there for so many years is an understatement. So I'd like to add my voice of support to the project. I actually was one of the people early on that was encouraging the administration to support this, and I'm pleased that it now has come to this point. So thank you for the opportunity to join with you tonight. I know that this is going to be a productive and interesting interchange or exchange of ideas and comments. And again, congratulations to Mike Kelly and Heather and the very able staff of the Chicago Park District for moving this project ahead. Good luck to everyone, and thank you again for giving me this opportunity.
Thank you so much, Alderman. We really appreciate your comments and your support, and we are so grateful to have you with us this evening. I'd also like to acknowledge that we have a representative from Alderman Lopez's office with us as well. So thank you all for joining us tonight. And with that, Alicia, I believe we can continue our presentation. Thank you.
Thank you, Heather. Okay, so tonight our team will present a brief history of the project. John Ronan from John Ronan Architects and Ernie Wong from Site Design Group will share details of the proposed field house, administrative office building, and park development. Finally, following the design presentation, there will be time to answer questions and hear comments from you. In order to help us run the questions and answer portion of the meeting efficiently, we welcome you to submit questions or comments on the project using the chat box starting right now, and continuing as we move through the presentation. Behind the scenes, our team will review and organize questions and comments by topic so that we are ready to share the questions and comments and provide thoughtful responses during the Q&A portion of the meeting. Nuestro equipo les presentará un pequeño historial de este proyecto. John Ronan, de la firma de arquitectura John Ronan Architects, y Ernie Wong, de Site Design Group, compartirán detalles del edificio, los servicios para la comunidad, oficinas y áreas verdes. Finalmente, después de esta presentación, habrá tiempo para contestar preguntas y escuchar sus comentarios. Les invitamos a enviar sus preguntas y comentarios desde ahora por medio del chat de este programa. Nuestro equipo estará leyendo las preguntas y comentarios durante toda la sesión para organizarlas y poder contestarlas apropiadamente. Heather will now share a bit of history regarding the project and review the input we have received thus far from the community. Heather nos dará un breve resumen de la historia de este proyecto y repaso de los comentarios hechos hasta ahora por la comunidad.
For a number of years, the Chicago Park District searched for a new home for its administrative headquarters. The Park District seriously considered 20 different locations. These included sites in the Loop and sites in neighborhoods across the city. After this long search, the Park District selected the site at 48th and Western because it provides significant value to the community and to the agency.
Durante varios años del Distrito de Parques de Chicago, estuvo buscando un lugar para ubicar sus oficinas centrales. La búsqueda tomó varios años. El Distrito de Parque investigó y consideró 20 lugares. La búsqueda finalmente terminó con la selección del área localizada en la esquina de la calle 48 y la avenida Western. Este lugar fue seleccionado porque traerá beneficios a la comunidad que está a su alrededor y porque es un lugar ideal para el distrito de parques.
The site offers direct access to public transportation via a major bus line and the CTA Orange Line, and the large acreage of the site makes it possible to provide significant indoor and outdoor recreational opportunities for people of all ages and abilities.
Esta propiedad ofrece acceso directo al transporte público como camiones con rutas mayores y a la línea de tren anaranjada. La propiedad es suficientemente grande para brindar actividades recreacionales para personas de todas las edades y habilidades, tanto al aire libre como en interiores.
The park will provide the Brighton Park community with a transformative investment. Currently, the Brighton Park community area is one of the top five community areas underserved by public open space. The new park will repurpose a 17-acre vacant former industrial site into a premier community open space.
Este parque es una inversión importante para Brighton Park. ya que esta comunidad es una de las 5 comunidades con menos acceso a áreas verdes. Este proyecto transformará esta propiedad industrial de 17 acres que no se usan en un bello parque para la comunidad.
To develop and refine the design program for the site that will be presented tonight, the Chicago Park District called upon the talents of its own staff, as well as members from the Brighton Park community. In early spring of 2020, we met with representatives from the Brighton Park Neighborhood Council and the Back of the Yards Council. Unfortunately, our first community meeting, which was planned for the end of March 2020, was canceled due to the shelter-in-place order. So in early April, we posted a project presentation online. We appreciate everyone who provided input on the project so far.
Para desarrollar y finalizar el programa de diseño del parque que se presentará hoy, el Distrito de Parques de Chicago ha reunido talento de su equipo, incluyendo la comunidad de Brighton Park. Al principio de este año, nos reunimos con representantes del Consejo Comunitario de Brighton Park y el de Back of the Yards. Desafortunadamente, nuestra primera junta comunitaria que estaba planeada para el fin de marzo fue cancelada por la orden de permanecer en casa. Con este limitante en abril, se publicó una presentación en el Internet. Agradecemos los que han enviado sus comentarios desde entonces.
Some common themes that emerged through the preliminary community engagement, ideas we've heard so far from the community include ensuring safety and security of patrons within the park, including indoor spaces and activities for older children and teens, including opportunities for public art, allowing community members the opportunity to weigh in on programming provided at the fieldhouse and in the park, ensuring facilities and programming are accessible and affordable to community members, providing the opportunity for community members to help name the park and field house, and to consider some additional ideas for program elements, such as a pool, a running track, a skateboard park, and a dome over the soccer field.
Algunos de los comentarios recibidos son los siguientes. Garantizar la seguridad y protección de los usuarios. Incluir en el edificio espacios para actividades para niños más grandes y adolescentes. Incluir oportunidades relacionadas con arte. Brindar a los miembros de la comunidad la oportunidad de participar en la creación de los programas de espacios públicos en el edificio y áreas verdes. Asegurar que los programas del parque sean accesibles y económicos para los miembros de la comunidad. Dar oportunidad a miembros de la comunidad a contribuir con nombres para el parque y el edificio. Y considerar algunas ideas adicionales para los programas del parque como una piscina, una pista de carrera, un parque para patinar o una cúpula de fútbol.
The Park District and Design Team have already incorporated some of these suggestions into the plans, and we will highlight these aspects of the plan in the next portion of the presentation. Programming suggestions will be addressed as programming is developed for the site. We look forward to discussing these ideas and others with you tonight. Please note that although the Park District may not be able to accommodate all of the ideas brought forth tonight as part of Park 596, be sure that we are listening and taking note of all of your suggestions. We anticipate starting a Brighton Park Community Framework Plan sometime in 2021 to continue the conversation about parks and recreation needs in this community.
El Distrito de Parques y el equipo de diseño han incorporado algunas sugerencias, las cuales verán en la siguiente presentación. Otras sugerencias se incluirán en la programación. Estamos entusiasmados en compartir y trabajar en estas ideas hoy con ustedes, pero por favor estén conscientes de que el Distrito de Parques no podrán incorporar todas las ideas propuestas para el Parque 596. Anticipamos el inicio de un plan comunitario en el año 2021 que documentará las sugerencias de la comunidad y de allí podremos continuar la conversación de las necesidades de la comunidad. Thank you for the background information, Heather. Next, we have architect John from John Ronan Architects and landscape architect Ernie Wong from Site Design Group. Milo Aguilar from AP Monarch will be translating. They will share an overview of the design for the park. Muchas gracias por la información, Heather. A continuación, tenemos el arquitecto John Ronan de John Ronan Architects y el paisajista Ernie Wong de Site Design Group. Ellos van a compartir más detalles para el parque y Milo Aguilar de AP Monarch estará traduciendo.
Thanks, Alicia. John Ronan Architects is excited to be part of this project and to have tonight's opportunity to share the progress on the design of the park with you.
Hola, John, qué gusto tenerte con nosotros. La firma de arquitectos de John Ronan está muy entusiasmada en formar parte de este proyecto y hoy poder compartir con ustedes los avances que se han hecho en el diseño del parque.
Park 596 is located along the Chicago Park and Boulevard system, a network of major parks connected by green boulevards. Our site is marked here in red, positioned along a segment of Western Avenue Boulevard between McKinley Park to the north and Gage Park to the south.
El Parque 596 está localizado a lo largo del sistema del Parque de Chicago y el sistema de bulevares. Este es un grupo de grandes parques conectados por bulevares que tienen vegetación. El área del parque la marcamos en rojo. Se ubica en el segmento de la avenida Western entre el Parque McKinley, localizado al norte, y el Parque Gage al sur.
The site is bounded by Western Avenue to the east, 48th Street to the north, and the Orange Line to the south. Across Rockwell Street to the west is James Shields Middle School.
El área está entre la calle Western al este, la calle 48 al norte, la línea anaranjada del tren al sur, al oeste la escuela James Shields, y cruzando está la calle Rockwell.
Historic Chicago field houses were located at the center of the park and helped organize the surrounding park landscape into programmatic zones. And this concept has been followed in the design of the new park.
Las casas de campo de Chicago usualmente se ubicaron en la parte central de los parques, creando subáreas. Este concepto se incorporó al diseño de este parque nuevo.
These are some photos of the site today.
Esta imagen muestra lo que actualmente existe.
The design concept for the park references the Chicago Park and Boulevard system with a continuous park pathway that widens out periodically into courtyards and plazas.
El concepto de diseño del parque está inspirado en parques de Chicago y el sistema de bulevares que tiene un camino que se va ampliando formando patios y plazas.
This pathway meanders through the park and bisects the building into two areas. One is the park district headquarters and the other area is the field house. Inboard of this path are recreation areas, two artificial turf playing fields accommodating soccer, football, and lacrosse, and a great lawn, which is a grassy multi-purpose area surrounded by trees. Outboard of the park pathway is a more naturalistic landscape of meadow and tall grasses, which you can see in the lighter green color, with looping pathways. To the north of the field house are three recreation areas for small children, a playground, a spray pool, and a nature play area.
Este camino interactúa en el parque y separa el edificio en dos áreas. Una es el edificio corporativo del Distrito de Parques de Chicago y la otra es el área con la casa del parque. A lo largo de este camino hay tres áreas de recreación, dos canchas con pasto artificial para fútbol, soccer y lacrosse y un área grande con pasto y rodeada de árboles. Fuera del camino hay zonas con vegetación natural que incluyen áreas con pasto. Esta es el área colorada con verde claro y caminos que forman circuitos. Hacia el norte de la casa del parque hay tres áreas recreativas para niños menores. Un área de juegos, un área con chorros de agua y un área de juegos que interactúan con la naturaleza.
Pedestrians enter the site from one of five plazas on the north and east sides of the park. Vehicular traffic enters the site at 48th Place and continues into the parking lot on the south side of the site.
Los peatones pueden entrar al parque por una de las cinco plazas ubicadas al norte y al este del parque. Los vehículos pueden entrar por la calle 48 Place al estacionamiento al sur de la propiedad.
This is a view of the park entrance on Western Avenue, looking towards the headquarters building.
Esta es la vista de la entrada al parque desde la avenida Western, con vista hacia la oficina central del Distrito de Parques de Chicago.
The great lawn to the west of the building is a large grassy multi-purpose area surrounded by trees. It supports recreation as well as park district and community events such as Movies in the Park, Shakespeare in the Park, Markets and Art Fairs.
El espacio abierto o Great Lawn al oeste del edificio es un espacio multiuso rodeado de árboles. Está diseñado tanto para el uso y deleite del Distrito de Parques de Chicago como para la comunidad, así como para proyectar películas en el parque, obras teatrales y montado de mercados y ferias.
This is the ground floor plan of the field house, which can be entered either from the north or from the south.
Este es el plano de piso del primer nivel de la casa del parque, el cual se puede accesar por el norte y sur del edificio.
On the lower right is a view of one of the courtyards, which serve as outdoor meeting and relaxation areas, as well as light wells to bring daylight into the center of the building. The walls of the courtyard are made of Chicago common brick. This was done to help connect the building and integrate it with the building style of the surrounding community.
Esta es la vista de uno de los patios interiores que sirve como espacio para reuniones o meditación y a la vez dejan entrar luz natural al centro del edificio. Las paredes del patio interior serán construidas con ladrillo típico de Chicago. La intención es integrar este edificio nuevo con los edificios que ya se encuentran en la comunidad.
The fitness area is comprised of two rooms, one for fitness machines and the other for group exercise. Both have views into the courtyard.
El área de gimnasio estará compuesta de dos espacios, uno para máquinas de ejercicio y otro para clases en grupo. Ambos tienen vista hacia el patio interior.
This is a view of the gymnasium with built-in bleachers looking north.
Esta es la vista hacia los asientos de gimnasio viendo hacia el norte.
The Fieldhouse Club Room can be divided into two smaller rooms, each with a view of the Great Lawn to the west of the building.
La sala de club se puede dividir en dos espacios más pequeños, ambos con vista hacia el área de multiusos o gran patio al oeste del edificio.
On the second level of the field house is an outdoor covered terrace, which can be rented out for parties and events.
En el segundo piso de la casa del parque, habrá una terraza cubierta para eventos que podrá ser rentada para fiestas y actividades privadas.
This is a view from that event terrace, looking toward the great lawn with the playing fields beyond.
Esta es la vista de la terraza de eventos viendo hacia el gran patio y las canchas de juego.
This is a view of the courtyard at night.
Esta es la vista de noche de uno de los patios interiores.
Community space is a priority for this project. This slide highlights some of the outdoor spaces which can be reserved by the community: the great lawn to the west of the building and the playing fields.
Una de las prioridades de este proyecto son los espacios comunitarios. Esta imagen muestra algunos de los espacios exteriores que pueden ser reservados por la comunidad, el espacio multiusos y las canchas deportivas.
Other community spaces in the building include the Fieldhouse Club Rooms and adjoining terrace, the Teen Center, the Group Fitness Room, the gym, and the boardroom of the headquarters building.
Otros espacios para la comunidad dentro del edificio son los salones de la clase club y la terraza, el centro juvenil, gimnasio y el salón de reuniones de la oficina central del Distrito de Parques de Chicago.
And also the covered outdoor event terrace on the second level. It has support spaces for catering and furniture storage.
Y la terraza cubierta para eventos que está en el segundo piso tendrá un espacio para guardar mobiliario y área para banquetes.
At night, the building takes on a lantern-like quality. There will be pathway and security lighting throughout the park to support public safety.
El edificio cuenta con una intensa iluminación, la cual hará verse como una gran linterna por la noche. Todos los caminos del parque cuentan con muy buena iluminación que ayudarán a la seguridad pública.
This is an aerial view of the project looking northeast with the surrounding community and the downtown beyond. Now I'll turn it over to Ernie Wong from Site Design Group, who will tell us more about the playground areas.
Esta es la vista aérea viendo al noreste del lugar en donde se aprecia la comunidad y a lo lejos los edificios del centro de la ciudad. Ahora le cedemos la palabra a Ernie Wong de Site Design Group, quien nos dará más detalles acerca de las áreas de juego para los niños.
Muchas gracias, John. Hola, yo soy Inessa Wong de Site Design Group. Located north of the Great Lawn, the play area is divided into four main components: an entry plaza and fountain, traditional playground, natural play area, and sculptural water feature.
Al norte del patio de usos múltiples se encuentran cuatro áreas: la plaza y fuente de entrada, una área de juegos tradicionales, una área de juegos de interacción con la naturaleza y el área de esculturas acuáticas.
These play spaces serve as an extension of the surrounding recreational areas, encouraging children to move between the lawn, over small hills, through trees, and between features with ease.
Estos espacios de juego sirven como una extensión de las áreas recreacionales, invitando a que los niños exploren con facilidad el área verde, subiendo pequeñas colinas y caminando entre árboles, en las cuales encontrarán interesantes piezas.
The entry plaza welcomes you into the site from the north with a series of pools that fill and drain with water-activated paddles. Sculpture elements and seating surround the fountain.
La plaza de la entrada dará la bienvenida a los visitantes que llegan al norte con una serie de alberquitas que se llenan y vacían por medio de remos que se activan con agua. Elementos esculturales y área para sentarse estarán localizados alrededor de esta fuente.
South of the entry plaza, a large traditional playground focuses on climbing, motion, and accessibility through topographical features and custom design elements. This dynamic play space is unlike anything else in Chicago.
Al sur de la plaza de la entrada está un área grande con juegos tradicionales que se enfocan en actividades para escalar, moverse activamente y explorar caminos interesantes entre elementos del diseño. Este espacio será dinámico y único en su tipo en la ciudad de Chicago.
A water feature serves as a transition between the traditional playground and nature play space, with a bridge allowing dry passage between them. Water moves between varying height stone blocks through the use of a hand pump system and a runnel.
Entre el área de juegos tradicionales y el área de juegos con la naturaleza, habrá un elemento de agua que servirá de transición y un puente que ayudará para pasar sin mojarse. El agua se mueve a diferentes alturas entre piedras y un arroyo con el uso de un sistema de bombas.
The easternmost play feature is the natural play area, which includes creative nature-based play elements to encourage interaction and exploration with nature. This space features a series of freeform build areas, climbing elements, and block features that mimic the city skyline. Vegetation, topography, and unique custom elements such as upside-down trees make this a unique play space for children.
Al este se encuentra el área de juegos que interactúa con la naturaleza. Habrá elementos creados basados en la naturaleza que invitan a los visitantes a interactuar y explorarla. Este espacio tiene una serie de áreas para construir elementos libremente, estructuras para escalar y elementos como bloques que asemejan los rascacielos de la ciudad. La vegetación topográfica y elementos únicos como los nidos de aves hechos a escala humana, y árboles volteados al revés que logran que esta área de juego sea única para los niños.
Tying into the adjacent landscape features, the play spaces will provide diversified, engaging, and unique play experiences for children of all ages and abilities.
En coexistencia con las áreas jardinadas, los diversos juegos ayudarán a que los niños de todas las edades y habilidades diferentes interactúen.
Thank you, John and Ernie, for sharing these updates and for your work on designing this park. We hope the images and information have been helpful to visualize the park and the new amenities coming to the community. Heather will now share a couple of next steps for the project. Gracias, John y Ernie, por compartir los avances del diseño de este parque. Esperemos que las imágenes e información que se presentaron sean de ayuda para darse una idea del diseño del parque y los servicios que se están incluyendo para la comunidad. A continuación, Heather compartirá algunos siguientes pasos para el proyecto.
Thank you, Alicia, and thank you to everyone for participating this evening. I want to give you an overview of what we see as next steps in this process. We have a project website that we will put up on the screen, but you can also search Chicago Park District Park 596 to find it. We also have a plan to provide a community status update later this fall. The Park District is also seeking city approvals through the Chicago Plan Commission and City Council this fall. Our targeted construction start is winter 2020 with an approximate 12-month term anticipated for construction. We plan to begin a Brighton Park framework plan with the community in 2021.
Gracias a todos por su participación esta noche. Les quiero dar una descripción general de los próximos pasos en este proceso. Tenemos un sitio de web para el proyecto y lo pondremos en pantalla, pero también se puede encontrar haciendo búsqueda de Distrito de Parques de Chicago, Parque 596. Un reporte será disponible a la comunidad este otoño. El distrito también está buscando aprobaciones de la ciudad a través de Comisión de Planeación y el concejal de la ciudad este otoño. La construcción está programada para el invierno del 2020, con un plazo previsto de aproximadamente 12 meses. Planeamos comenzar un plan comunitario de Brighton Park en el año 2021. Now, we will take a five-minute break to allow the project team to prepare for the questions and answers portion of tonight's meeting. Remember to keep in touch about the project. Please be sure to fill out the virtual sign-in sheet. You will see the link in the chat box. Ahora tomaremos un descanso de 5 minutos para permitir que nuestro equipo se prepare para el segmento de preguntas y respuestas de la reunión. Por favor, se puede mantener en contacto rellenando la forma que se encontrará en el link del chat. Welcome back. We will now move to the question and answer portion of this session. We know some of you have provided questions and comments in advance. Others may have some now. Again, please share your questions or comments using the chat function. Ahora continuemos con el segmento de preguntas y respuestas. Algunos de ustedes ya nos han mandado sus preguntas y comentarios, pero pueden seguir enviándolas en el chat.
Thank you, Alicia, and thanks to everyone who has submitted questions and comments this evening and in advance of the meeting. My name is Sarah White, and I will moderate the question and answer session. During the break, we compiled questions and comments received so far and have organized a list that we will run through now. I will read each question or comment, and I will ask a member of our project team to respond. In addition, the team of presenters you heard tonight already, Art Richardson, Central Region Manager, and Dennis Gonzalez, Area Manager, will participate in the Q&A session to help answer questions about park programming and operations. Please note that while we'll do our best to address all the comments and questions we received this evening, in the interest of time, questions pertaining to the same subject have been condensed and summarized. CPD will provide a complete transcript of all comments and questions received during this meeting as part of the meeting summary, which CPD will post to the project website sometime next week.
Gracias, Alicia. Hola, nuevamente soy Mile. Continuaré traduciendo las preguntas y respuestas que a continuación Sarah White tiene para nuestro panel. Gracias a todos los que han enviado preguntas y comentarios esta noche y antes de esta reunión. Mi nombre es Sarah White y moderaré el segmento de preguntas y respuestas. Durante el descanso, hemos recopilado las preguntas y comentarios recibidos hasta el momento y las hemos organizado en una lista que revisaremos ahora. Leeré cada pregunta y comentario y le pediré a un miembro de nuestro equipo que responda. Además de los presentadores que han escuchado hablar esta noche, Art Richardson, gerente de la región central, y Dennis González, gerente del área, participarán en la sesión de preguntas y respuestas para ayudar a responder preguntas sobre la programación y las operaciones del parque. Haremos todo lo posible para abordar todos los comentarios y preguntas que recibimos esta noche. Debido a que el tiempo es limitado, las preguntas se han condensado y resumido por tema. El Distrito de Parque de Chicago proporcionará una transcripción completa de todos los comentarios y preguntas recibidas durante esta reunión como parte del resumen, que publicará en el sitio web del proyecto durante la próxima semana.
Thank you, Milo. We'll start with questions pertaining to the site plan and site program. First question. There is high demand for indoor and outdoor pool time in the community. Did the park district consider a swimming pool at Park 596? I'm going to direct this question to Heather Gleason.
La primera pregunta está dirigida para el sitio y es que si la comunidad ha expresado una necesidad para el uso de la piscina interior y exterior. Se consideró el Distrito de Parques de Chicago incluir una piscina para este parque 596. La respuesta la dará Heather Gleason.
Based on community feedback regarding a perceived lack of access to swimming pools, the park district reviewed the possibility of including an outdoor and indoor pool at the site. Due to space and budget constraints, CPD is not able to include a swimming pool at Park 596. However, the Park District is looking for other ways to expand access to swimming pools in the community, and this topic we will cover in the upcoming framework plan for Brighton Park.
En base a los comentarios de la comunidad con respecto a la falta de una piscina, el Distrito de Parques de Chicago analizó la posibilidad de incluir una piscina al aire libre o cubierta en el sitio. Debido a las limitaciones de espacio y el presupuesto, no puede incluir una piscina en este parque, pero está considerando para el plan de trabajo futuro de este parque hacer algo al respecto.
All right, next question. Street parking is sometimes at a premium in the neighborhood, especially when school is in session, and Shields Middle School staff use street parking along 48th Street. How did the Park District determine the number of parking spaces on site?
Okay, la pregunta es, el estacionamiento en la calle a veces es escaso en el vecindario, especialmente cuando la escuela está en sesión y el personal de Shields Middle School usa el estacionamiento a lo largo de la calle 48. ¿Cómo determinó el Distrito de Parques de Chicago la cantidad de espacio de estacionamiento en el sitio? And who is responding?
Heather Gleason will respond to this. Ernie Wong will respond to this question.
Yeah, I certainly can. Great question. The site currently accommodates 204 off-street parking spaces in a gated lot. Chicago Park District and the design team considered a number of factors when determining the quantity of these parking spaces, including the location of nearby transit facilities, applicable zoning regulations, number of staff that will be working at the headquarters in the field house, and anticipated park uses based on the site program.
Actualmente, el sitio tiene capacidad para 204 espacios de estacionamiento fuera de la vía pública en un lote cerrado. CPD y el equipo de diseño consideraron una serie de factores para determinar la cantidad de espacio de estacionamiento, incluyendo la ubicación del transporte público cercano, las restricciones de zonificación, la cantidad de personal que trabaja en la sede y la casa de campo, así como los usos previstos del parque, según el programa de diseño.
Thank you. Another parking question up next. Will the operation of the Park District Administrative Building impact street parking around the site?
Otra pregunta con respecto al estacionamiento es que si el funcionamiento del edificio administrativo del Distrito de Parques de Chicago afectará al estacionamiento de las calles aledañas al sitio.
So I can take that question. The Park District is aware that the community uses the uncontrolled street parking on Rockwell and that Shields Middle School staff during school hours. The Park District does not intend for our staff to use street parking during administrative building office hours. Additionally, the Park District is evaluating nearby options for accessory parking to serve large-scale events that may take place at the park. For example, nearby parking lots that could serve as overflow parking on a weekend afternoon to accommodate visitors to a soccer tournament, for instance, or a festival.
CPD está consciente de que la comunidad usa el estacionamiento en la calle Rockwell y que es particularmente importante para el personal de Shields Middle School durante el horario escolar. CPD no tiene la intención de que el personal use el estacionamiento en la calle durante el horario de oficinas del edificio administrativo. Además, CPD está considerando opciones para estacionamiento adicional que pueda servir cuando hay eventos grandes en el parque. Por ejemplo, lotes cercanos que puedan servir como estacionamiento adicional por las tardes en fin de semana para los visitantes de un torneo de fútbol o festival.
Thank you. And we just received a quick follow-up question on parking. So Heather, I'm going to pass this one to you. Who will be able to use the on-site parking that we're building?
Sure, good question. So the Park District and Fieldhouse parking that you see on the diagram is 204 spaces as we've currently planned it. And the Park District staff will definitely be using it during the day. But we do anticipate when people come to use the fields and the other amenities at the site that the public will also be able to use it.
La pregunta era que quién tendrá acceso a ese estacionamiento que está planeado para el parque. Y la respuesta es que principalmente la gente que trabaja en la oficina podrá utilizar el estacionamiento, pero también gente que va a visitar el parque tendrá acceso al estacionamiento si es necesario.
Thank you. Another site access question. How will access to and from the new park function when school drop-off and pickup occurs and access to the Rockwell cul-de-sac is closed? Heather, I'm going to pass this one to you again.
Otra pregunta es, ¿cómo es el acceso del nuevo parque cuando se llevan y recogen alumnos de la escuela y se tiene que cerrar el callejón sin salida de Rockwell?
We understand, based on previous conversations with stakeholders, that access to the Rockwell cul-de-sac will be prohibited during school drop-off and pickup hours. The entry is about 7:45 a.m. to 8:30 a.m., and dismissal at the school is 2:45 p.m. to 3:30 p.m. During these times, visitors accessing the park, fieldhouse, or administration building will use the access into the site at 48th Place and Western Avenue.
Por conversaciones previas, tenemos entendido que el acceso a través del callejón sin salida de Rockwell estará prohibido durante las horas de entrada y salida de la escuela, que es entre las 7:45 de la mañana y 8:30, y la salida de 2:45 a 3:30 de la tarde. Durante este horario, los visitantes que accedan al parque, la casa de campo o el edificio administrativo utilizarán la entrada en la calle 48 Place y Western Avenue.
Next question, how does the park district intend to incorporate public art into the building and site? This question will be answered by John Ronan.
La pregunta es, ¿cómo pretende el Distrito Parque de Chicago incorporar el arte público al edificio y al sitio?
The site plan includes several locations around the perimeter at plazas designated to accommodate a rotating display of public art.
El plano del sitio incluye varios lugares designados para montar exhibiciones de arte público.
All right, thank you. Now we'll address some questions that we received live during the event this evening. First question, and I'm going to address this question to Ernie Wong from Site Design Group. How much and what kind of natural areas will the park have?
La pregunta es, ¿cuánta cantidad de áreas verdes y qué tipo de áreas verdes están planeando para este proyecto?
Great question. There are a number of natural areas surrounding both the playing fields as well as the headquarters. Those natural areas actually represent a savanna oak system as well as native prairie meadows.
Habrá varios estilos de naturaleza en el área del sitio. Algunos son con plantas nativas y otras que asemejan praderas.
Thank you. Next question. This one I'm also going to ask Ernie Wong to respond to. Someone in the meeting said, I would like the project to include room for activities all year long. Describe how the site accommodates activity through the year.
La pregunta es que se está solicitando que haya un espacio para que se puedan hacer actividades durante todo el año en este proyecto. Y si se consideró algo similar.
So we think that the park is going to be able to provide four season activity. Certainly there are two things that occur. One of them is that the artificial playing fields, because of their material, will be able to be played on for pretty much most of the year. I know that in our experience from other artificial playing fields, the snow melts very, very quickly on that. So I've seen soccer being played on the artificial fields year round. The other, though, is some of these natural areas also provide some very interesting wintertime activities as well. The park that we designed at Palmisano Park, people use that year round to just walk through the natural areas and see some of the activity that goes on through that throughout the entire year.
Según lo que se hizo para este proyecto, una de las canchas están hechas con pasto artificial, la cual puede usarse durante todo el año. Y también las áreas verdes que se están diseñando sirven y estarán activas durante todo el año, inclusive en el invierno. La gente podrá caminar y realizar actividades en estas zonas.
Thank you. Another question for Ernie. Are the park and grounds ADA accessible?
Yes, that's always a big part of the way we design. The entire park will be ADA accessible, even including the playground areas that we anticipate. And we were very careful to make sure that all of the sloping areas were sloped gently enough to be able to accommodate accessibility at all of all kinds.
Claro que sí, todas las áreas de juego se están considerando para acceso para minusválidos, al igual que los caminamientos tienen unas pendientes suaves para que puedan circular con sus equipos de circulación.
Thank you. The next question is, since the site was previously an industrial site, is site remediation, environmental remediation specifically, a part of this project? Ernie, I'd like to pass this one to you again.
There is a remediation. Oh, go ahead. Go ahead, Mila.
La pregunta es que el parque se está haciendo en un lote que tenía antes un uso para industria. Y si ahora cumple con los requisitos de EPA, que es para que tenga, para que no sea dañino para la salud de la comunidad.
So as the as construction starts, there will be a remediation plan in place, knowing full well that this used to be an industrial site. I believe testing is occurring, has already occurred, and more will take place as well to accommodate the proper remediation practices.
Ya se hicieron algunas pruebas y también se hará antes de iniciar la construcción un plan de remediación para las áreas afectadas por la industria.
Thank you. I'll give Ernie a break for a minute. Heather, next question is for you. Is there an opportunity for baseball to be added to the site?
Thank you for the question. So at this time, we don't have baseball designed into the program. That is one of the reasons why we wanted to start a framework plan with the community very shortly after when we get started in 2021, so that we can look at other things that you're interested in. As I mentioned, Brighton Park is one of the areas in the city that is one of the top five communities in need of open space. So we anticipate that we'll be having all of those discussions with you at that time.
La pregunta era que si había, se había planeado para un campo de béisbol en el sitio y hasta ahorita no se ha planeado nada así, pero se planea tener más juntas con la comunidad para que en el plan de trabajo del 2021 pueda hacerse algo al respecto.
Thank you. Next question for Ernie again. Will more trees be added to the parkway along the streets?
La pregunta es que si se instalarán o se plantarán más árboles a lo largo de las calles de este parque.
Sorry, my mute button kept on going off. Yes, the City of Chicago Landscape Ordinance requires parkway plantings along all major streets, so 25 feet on center. Throughout the entire park, we're planning on somewhere around 350 new trees. So that's going to provide quite a bit of shade as well throughout the entire park.
Se van a plantar por lo menos 360 árboles en todo este 360 árboles en este proyecto y a lo largo de 25 pies de una de las calles. What street did you say? I'm sorry, I missed that one.
Along the all of the major streets, so Western Avenue and 48th Street will have street trees planted 25 feet on center.
Sí, todo a lo largo de todas las calles se plantará 25 pies de longitud de árboles nuevos. Así es.
Thank you. Next question. Is a garden included as part of the plan? Ernie, could you take this one as well?
Quit picking on me.
You're in the hot seat.
You know, so we have planned for a meadow and some nature play areas. I think that a garden, the Chicago Park District has been doing gardens through community meetings in terms of trying to figure out who will maintain those as well. So I think that that is an applicable use, but it will have to be talked about through community meetings.
La pregunta era que si se había considerado un jardín comunitario para este proyecto. Y según lo que se entiende, se ha platicado al respecto, pero aún no se decide si va a haber todavía uno. Tienen que seguir las pláticas con la comunidad.
Thank you. I'm going to read two more questions about the site plan, and then we're going to move on to questions about the building and the building program. So second to last question about the site plan, Ernie, again for you, are any non-native tree species included as part of the planting plan?
There are, a few. We have tried to stay to a native plant species as much as possible. However, there are some non-natives that may occur, particularly with some of the ornamental trees, as well as a couple of evergreens. But for the most part, most of the trees will be native.
La pregunta era que si se está, que tantos árboles o plantas no son nativas para este proyecto. Y según lo que se entiende es que la mayoría de las plantas serán nativas, a excepción de algunas decorativas que se están proponiendo, pero en realidad la mayor parte es planta nativa.
Thank you. And the final question pertaining to the site that we'll talk about this evening, will outlets be included on light poles or the exterior of the building so that the public may charge electronic devices? I think I'm going to start with Ernie on this one, and he can kick it back to me if he would like to.
Yeah, so we're still working on the lighting plan in terms of, you know, how many light fixtures are located throughout the entire park. Will all of those have an ability for people to plug in? We aren't quite sure yet. But I believe that there will be some more opportunities for that to occur.
La pregunta fue si habría, se estaba considerando poner contactos para cargar aparatos eléctricos personales para la gente que visita el parque. En algunas secciones hay algunos contactos, pero podría seguirse platicando para ver si aumenta la cantidad y la gente pueda utilizar este servicio.
Thank you. And Ernie, just one more question that just came in. What other parks has Site Design Group designed?
So we've done a number of parks for the park district. Probably one that is more similar to this will be the Palmisano Park in Bridgeport. that's at Halsted and 29th Street. And it's adjacent to McGuane Park, which also has a lot of athletic facilities as well. So that's right down Archer Avenue from this site. We've also done Pingtown Memorial Park along the Chicago River. We have done Lakeshore East, which is downtown in the Loop. And we're currently working on Seneca Park, which is on the Gold Coast. Oh, one more park that is, I think, also very important if people want to see that is Park 574, which is over Rockwell and just west of this site, actually, just a little north and west of this site.
La pregunta fue si Site Design ha diseñado otros parques que se puedan referir. Y sí hay uno que se llama Palmera Park, que está en Halsted y 20, y la calle 29. Otro que es un parque memorial. Otro que está en la Gold Coast, que se llama Seneca Park. Y uno que se llama el Parque 74, que está en la calle Rockwell, cerca de este parque que ahorita estamos platicando.
All right, thanks everyone. We're going to move on to questions that we've received pertaining to the building and the fieldhouse program. Similar to the site questions, I'm going to start by reading questions that we received in advance of the meeting, and then we will answer questions that we received or during the meeting itself. First question. There is a need in the community for more indoor space to accommodate activities for older children and teens. How will this need be addressed by the project? I will ask John Ronan to answer this question.
La pregunta es que si la comunidad necesita más espacio interior para que los niños mayores y adolescentes realicen actividades, ¿cómo se está considerando esta necesidad en este proyecto?
The fieldhouse includes a number of spaces that may accommodate programs and activities for older children and teens. These would include the gym, which has a full-size basketball court, the fitness rooms, and the club rooms. The fieldhouse plan also has a teen center space near the north entrance that will be dedicated for use by older kids.
La casa de campo incluye una serie de espacios donde se pueden brindar actividades para niños mayores y adolescentes, como un gimnasio, como una cancha de básquetbol de tamaño completo, salón para ejercitarse y salas para reuniones. El plan de la casa de campo también incluye un centro para adolescentes que se dedicará a los niños mayores.
Thank you. Next question for Heather Gleason. How many park district staff will work at the administrative building?
La pregunta es, ¿qué cantidad de personal del Distrito de Parques trabajará en el edificio administrativo?
Thank you for the question. So the park district anticipates that at full capacity, approximately 200 staff will work at the administration building.
El Parque del Distrito de Chicago planea que la capacidad será aproximadamente de 200 miembros de personas que trabajen en este edificio administrativo.
Thank you. Next question, I'll ask Dennis Gonzalez to answer for us. How will CPD ensure that indoor and outdoor community spaces are accessible and affordable for community members?
La pregunta es, ¿cómo garantizará el parque de distritos que los espacios comunitarios interiores y exteriores sean accesibles y económicos para los miembros de la comunidad?
Thank you. The Chicago Park District will establish reasonable indoor and outdoor community space rentals. These rates have not been developed yet. We understand that there is a great need for accessible and affordable community space in Bryan Park, and we will keep this in mind as we establish the plan for fees and rates.
Establecerá cuotas razonables de espacios comunitarios interiores y exteriores. Las tarifas aún no se han decidido, pero entendemos que existe una gran necesidad del espacio comunitario accesible y económico para Brickton Park, y lo tendremos en cuenta al establecer el plan de cuotas y tarifas.
Thank you. Now we'll answer some questions submitted during the meeting regarding the building and fieldhouse program. Similar to the site, describe how the building accommodates activity throughout the year for community members. John Ronan, can you please take this one?
La pregunta es, igual que para hacer actividades en el parque, ¿qué actividades se podrán realizar en el edificio del parque?
Yeah, the park, the field house, of course, is open year round. All the spaces inside are year round spaces. We do have terraces off of the club rooms with they have radiant heat in the slabs so that those can be used in the wintertime too. And then the courtyards, we have radiant heating in the pathway that runs through the building. So those courtyards that are that you see, the open air courtyards that are internal to the building, those have radiant heating, so they don't collect snow. So those can be used in the wintertime as well.
Principalmente los patios interiores del edificio están equipados con sistemas para que la nieve o el hielo no se acumule, por lo cual lo hace que se puedan utilizar durante todo el año. Y además, en el interior del edificio, los salones que están disponibles para renta u otras actividades pueden ser usados por la gente.
Thank you. One more for John. What bird-friendly features are incorporated into the design?
Yes.
Okay. La pregunta es, ¿qué estrategias para proteger a los pájaros se están considerando para este parque?
So we did take bird safety into consideration in the design of the building. The exterior, the perimeter of the circular building is glazed. But outboard of the glazing, we have a sunscreen, which is an anodized aluminum element. And this provides two functions. It provides sun shading to minimize heat gain into the building, but it also allows birds to more easily see the building. And then the area below the sunshade, from grade to the bottom of the sunshade, we can put a bird-friendly fritting, which is basically a permanent decal on the glass to make it easier to see for birds.
Sí se están implementando algunas cosas, como por ejemplo para el edificio circular, el vidrio que se utiliza es esmerilado y también tiene un acabado en aluminio que hace que los pájaros lo vean y no choquen contra él. Además, en los espacios que tienen sombra, se está protegiendo de alguna manera para que los pájaros no se queden atorados en esas zonas.
Thank you. Now we'll review questions related to programming and fees for the new park. The first question I'll direct to Dennis. What types of programs will the park district offer at the new park? And Dennis, I'm going to tag on a second piece to this question that came in during our meeting. Since there's senior housing across Western Avenue, how will programming for seniors be addressed at the site?
La pregunta es, ¿qué tipo de programas se van a impartir en el parque? Y ya que hay un edificio de vivienda para gente de la tercera edad, ¿si hay actividades para ellos también considerándose en este parque?
Thank you for the question. So the Chicago Park District staff is in the process of establishing the plan for program offerings at the park and fieldhouse. The Chicago Park District understands that there is a need in the community for affordable and accessible youth programming, summer programs, and specifically recreation programs for older kids and teens. And as well as for seniors, we will take into consideration, what the community needs and try to build programming around that aspect as well.
Sí, se están considerando que las actividades para el parque sean relacionadas con actividades de niños de todas las edades y adultos, por lo que se tiene un programa que tenemos que seguirlo comentando con la comunidad.
Thank you. I'd like to direct the next question to Heather Gleason. Will there be a parking fee charge for park and field house visitors?
La pregunta es que si habrá cuotas y tarifas de entrada para estacionamiento y al parque.
Thank you for the question. The Park District is in the process of developing the operational plan for the site, so parking fees for the site have not been determined whether we'll have them or not. We understand the community's preference to avoid parking fees on site.
El parque está en proceso de desarrollar un plan de operativo para el sitio, pero aún no se han determinado las tarifas de estacionamiento. Pretendemos que la comunidad no pague tarifas de estacionamiento en el parque.
Thank you. Next, we'll address questions pertaining to park safety and security. First question. This one I'll direct to Heather Gleason. It is important that security is addressed as part of the park design. Please describe how CPD plans to address safety and security at the new park.
Es importante que la seguridad se considere como parte del diseño del parque. Describa cómo el parque planea proveer seguridad y protección dentro de él.
Thank you. Safety and security are definitely prioritized in the physical design of the park. So the site plan includes ample sight lighting and clear sight lines to help ensure the safety of park visitors. Security cameras are also included in the plan to provide surveillance in indoor and outdoor public spaces. The Park District is still finalizing the operational plan, but preliminarily, we plan to have 24-hour security staff present on the site. The development of the new park also means that the site will be activated and we'll have more people there, and so it should feel more safe and secure just by having an active site in a more 24-hour basis.
La seguridad y la protección son prioridad en la estructura de este parque. El plano del sitio incluye amplia iluminación y líneas de visión claras para ayudar y garantizar la seguridad de los visitantes del parque. Cámaras de seguridad también están incluidas en el proyecto para vigilar los espacios públicos interiores y exteriores. El Distrito de Parque de Chicago aún está finalizando el plan operativo para el sitio, pero se planea tener presencia de personal de seguridad a las 24 horas. El desarrollo del parque nuevo también quiere decir que el sitio estará activado y que tiene más gente usando el sitio hacia el área más segura, para sentir el área más segura.
Thank you. Next question to Heather Gleason again. Will a new traffic signal be constructed at the building entrance at 48th Place and Western Avenue to ensure safety of park visitors and pedestrians?
La pregunta es que si se instalará un nuevo semáforo en la entrada del edificio en la calle 48 Place y Western para garantizar la seguridad de los visitantes y peatones del parque.
Yes, we have completed a draft traffic study and are currently working with both CDOT and IDOT to finalize plans for pedestrian improvements to the 48th Place intersection. A traffic signal is being considered as part of these improvements, and our plans are currently under review with the City's Department of Transportation and the Illinois Department of Transportation.
El Distrito de Parque de Chicago ha finalizado un estudio preliminario de tráfico y está trabajando con CDOT y IDOT, que son los departamentos de transporte de la ciudad y el estado, para finalizar los planes de mejoras para peatones en la esquina 48 Place. Se está considerando instalar un semáforo como parte de estas mejorías y los planes se encuentran actualmente bajo revisión de estas instituciones.
Thank you. Now we'll address some miscellaneous questions that have come in about the park. And I'm going to start with one that just came in from a meeting participant. What will be the tallest structure in the park? I'm going to pass this one to John Ronan.
La pregunta es, acaba de llegar y se pregunta que cuál sería el elemento más alto dentro de este parque.
The tallest element in the park is the building, the headquarters building itself. And the sunscreen that I mentioned earlier goes about 3 feet above the parapet. And then on top of the roof, we have a green roof with green roof plantings and some rooftop mechanical units. So technically they would be the tallest elements and they would be about 45 feet off the ground to the top of the rooftop unit.
Básicamente el edificio es el espacio más alto que existe en este parque. Y arriba del edificio todavía hay un techo verde que la altura se prevé que sea, considerando el edificio, 45 pies. Además de esta área sombreada que es como un tipo de lona que lo hace que se vea alto desde lo lejos.
Thank you. Next question. What is the process for naming the park? And how can the community be involved in determining the name for the park and or field house? I'd like to ask Heather to answer this question.
La pregunta es, ¿cuál es el proceso para nombrar el parque? ¿Cómo puede participar la comunidad en la determinación del nombre del parque o casa de campo?
The park district has a written process for naming unnamed parks, which is what we would consider this park. A proposal for the park name can be proposed by the community, and then it is reviewed and approved by the Park District Board of Commissioners. The process requires a 45-day comment period prior to final board approval of the name.
El Instituto de Parque de Chicago tiene un proceso escrito para nombrar parques. La comunidad puede proponer una propuesta para el nombre del parque y será revisada y aprobada por la Junta de Concesionados del Parque. El proceso toma aproximadamente 45 días entre la revisión de sugerencias y aprobación final de la mesa directiva.
The next question is again for Heather Gleason and pertains to project schedule. Heather, can you talk about what phase the project design is in right now? If a general contractor has been selected for the site, when construction will start, and when the park and field house will be open to the public?
Certainly. Oh, sorry, Milo, go ahead.
La pregunta es si se tiene alguna fecha de inicio para la construcción, si ya hay, sorry, I missed one part of that. Can you repeat the question?
The first part is what phase of design are we in? The second part is has a general contractor been selected?
Okay. ¿Cuál etapa, en qué etapa de diseño se encuentra ahorita el parque? Si ya se consideró un contratista para construir el parque.
When will construction start and when will the park and field house be open?
¿Y cuándo se piensa iniciar trabajos de construcción y se pretende tener la casa de campo o abierta?
Okay, thank you. I'll try to answer all of those. And Milo, maybe I'll have you translate partway through to give you a break. So yes, the phase of design that we're in right now, we are in construction documents. And a big part of that is because the Park District really needs this new home. We are currently leasing space downtown from Northwestern, but they need our office space very quickly. They've been gracious to let us stay longer than planned. So that is partly why we asked John Ronan's team to do drawings for us very quickly so we could get those elements laid out. And then Milo, I'll let you translate that part.
La idea de construir es próxima porque tenemos nuestro contrato de renta ya se terminó en las oficinas que actualmente ocupamos y se extendió un poco, por eso es que le pedimos a los arquitectos que trabajaran en el proyecto lo más pronto posible.
Okay. I think the second part of that question was, has a general contractor been hired? And they have not. So there are opportunities, you know, we can get into more questions about local hiring in a moment, but we have not yet hired a general contractor. And as we discussed earlier in the presentation, our construction schedule is starting, we hope, this winter in 2020.
Por el momento, no se ha elegido ningún contratista para hacer los trabajos y como ya se dijo anteriormente, se pretende iniciar para el invierno de 2020.
And I think the last part of the question was when would the park and field house be open to the public? So we don't have an exact date yet, but we anticipate that once we start construction, it's about a 12-month construction project. So we would assume that we will be open in the early part of 2022.
Y la última pregunta era cuándo se pretende tener el parque funcionando. Y según los cálculos, se tardaría un año en la construcción, por lo que se pretende que para el 2022 ya esté terminado y en operación.
All right, thank you guys. The next question is, how is local hiring being prioritized as part of the project? Heather, could you please speak to this?
La pregunta es, ¿cómo se cómo se da prioridad a la solicitud de trabajo por parte de para este proyecto?
We are following Park District as well as City of Chicago guidelines for local hiring as part of this construction process. We have not yet selected the contractor, as I mentioned, but we ask our contractors to commit to at least 26% MBE and 6% WBE on the job. They're also encouraged to hire 50% city residents as part of the project. The Park District also designated a project area for this project that includes the Brighton Park community area and the community areas surrounding Brighton Park, from which we ask the contractors to utilize both skilled and unskilled labor from these areas on the construction job.
Estamos guiándonos en los requisitos de la ciudad de Chicago para la contratación de trabajadores en la comunidad para lo relacionado con la construcción. No hemos seleccionado un contratista, pero le pedimos a nuestros contratistas que cumplan un requisito de tener el 26% para minority business y el 6% para women related business en este proyecto. También se insistirá que se contraten para este proyecto el 50% de personas con residencia en la ciudad. El Instituto de Parques de Chicago también incluirá a la comunidad de Brighton Park y comunidades aledañas como áreas para solicitar contratación de trabajadores de la construcción.
Thank you. Heather, I'm going to follow up with one other contract question that came in during the meeting. What is the breakdown of M and WBE participation for professional services in this contract, and how many Hispanic-owned firms are involved in professional services?
La pregunta es, ¿qué porcentaje de negocios con la designación MBE y WBE están considerándose para este proyecto como servicios profesionales?
Thank you for the question. Since we haven't awarded a contractor yet, there will certainly be more professional services and they will have to follow those guidelines that I just mentioned. If you're referring to the design contract, I don't have the percentages here, but certainly the team that you have presenting before you tonight is part of that diverse team that we put together to design this project. And we'd be happy to post more information on our website about that.
Con respecto a la parte de diseño, no tengo los porcentajes que actualmente vamos a utilizar, pero seguramente estamos queriendo que sea esto lo más diverso posible. Para la parte de construcción, como ya se dijo anteriormente, es el 26% para negocios que tengan designación MBE y 6% para designación WBE.
Thank you. We received a number of questions about jobs that will be available at the park after the park and field house open. Dennis, I'm going to pass this question to you. How will the community or local hiring be addressed when the park is open? And does the park district anticipate that jobs will be available at the park?
La pregunta es, ¿cómo se está considerando el contratar a la gente de la comunidad para esta casa de club cuando esté ya operando, para que se dé a conocer a la comunidad?
Thank you for the question. I would like to think that our human resource department would be handling the hiring in respect to jobs available, as long as it is not a bid position. There would be an opportunity for community members to apply for jobs that are not bid positions.
El Departamento de Recursos Humanos está encargando de esta situación y próximamente darán a conocer los puestos que están de alguna manera necesitando para este edificio.
Thank you. Next question. You mentioned an upcoming open space and recreation framework planning process for the Brighton Park community area. When is that starting and how can the community be involved? Heather, I'd like to throw this question to you.
La pregunta es que se mencionó que había un plan de trabajo futuro en donde la comunidad podría seguir participando y cuándo se podrá saber al respecto de esto, si tiene alguna fecha determinada.
Thank you. We anticipate starting the planning process next year in 2021, and we'll have an extensive community engagement effort that will be included in the project scope that, so that the community can have robust participation.
Planeamos tener este programa para el 2021, y por supuesto que tenemos que tener mucha comunicación y actividades con la comunidad.
Thank you. And Heather, I'm going to follow up with a related question that came in from the meeting today. A couple of questions came in about how can this development positively impact surrounding parks? And how will CPD invest in other parks that need new field houses?
Okay, la pregunta es cómo beneficiará este parque positivamente a otros parques aledaños y si se está pensando en invertir en otros parques en la ciudad.
Thank you for the question. So we certainly hope that this will benefit the whole community as we have this brand new resource here. I think what the question is alluding to is that a lot of neighborhoods and parks are looking for improvements. The Park District has a $30 million capital bond every year that we have to spread out between all of our 604 parks and 8,800 acres. Excuse me. So that is a challenge for us to balance that. However, we are very aggressive about applying for grants and looking for opportunities to partner. And I would anticipate that we would talk about those things during the framework plan.
El Distrito de Parque de Chicago cuenta con $30 millones que tiene que utilizar para mejorías en diferentes parques en la ciudad. Y tenemos que trabajar para poder saber en dónde es el destino de este dinero, por lo que de alguna manera las juntas comunitarias y el plan de 2021 tiene que estar listo y considerando esta inversión.
Thank you. Final question for the evening that we've got so far. And Heather, I'm going to ask you to lead this one. What will the aldermen do to help prevent gentrification and rising home prices, that circumstances that might occur from development of this site?
La pregunta es, ¿qué está pensando el concejal del distrito con respecto a cómo afectará los precios de vivienda en el área para y que no haya desalojo de gente porque los precios han subido demasiado?
Thank you. So I don't want to speak for the alderman, but I will attempt to answer that question sort of from a park district standpoint. I completely understand that is a concern. It's a challenge when we want investment in communities, and this is certainly something that we're excited to bring the community. And we recognize that being across from a park does have an impact on property values. It isn't in the park district's purview to control, private property values. But one of the things I think that you'll you'll see is that we, as Dennis mentioned this evening, we work really hard with the community to bring services that everyone can afford. One of our primary mottos at the Park District is we want to be the best deal in town. So the services that would be provided at the Park District, we would work with the community so to make sure that everyone can afford what we have to offer.
No quiero decir cosas que no debo decir, no que no debo decir, sino que palabras que podría decir directamente el concejal, pero lo que sí sé es que estamos trabajando para que todos los servicios que se den dentro de este parque sean prácticos y económicos para la gente de la comunidad. Y de tal manera, que no, sabemos que afectará a los precios de la comunidad, pero intentamos que sea de la mejor manera, con servicios necesarios.
Thank you, guys. I just want to wrap up with a couple of questions that came in towards the end here. John Ronan, can you please speak to this one? The outside of the building looked great for birds, but what about the interior windows or the inside patio areas?
Yeah, I think you're referring to the courtyard areas where we do have full height glass. So again, in those areas, we can put a ceramic frit on the glass that is designed to be visible to birds, like I mentioned, on the exterior of the building.
La pregunta es que, refiriéndose a cómo se protegen a los pájaros y que en el edificio exterior lo está considerando, ¿cómo se considera esto dentro en los patios que existen en el diseño? Y la respuesta fue que también se utilizará de alguna manera diseños en el vidrio para que los pájaros lo puedan identificar y no choquen contra él.
Thank you. I'd also like to acknowledge that we received a comment recommending the possibility of solar powered charging stations that we'll take into account. Finally, the last comment that we've received this evening, our community members being able to apply for jobs does not guarantee jobs though, so we understand and the priority and we'll take that into consideration. And then Heather, for the final question, can you please reiterate when will the community framework plan for Brighton Park take place and who will be able to join those discussions?
Se pregunta que cuando el plan de trabajo para el 2021 debe de estar iniciando para que la gente sepa y pueda participar, además de algunos comentarios que hubieron que se hace mención de utilizar paneles solares en el edificio. Y Heather nos va a dar la respuesta con respecto al plan de trabajo.
Thank you. Yes, we don't have a specific date yet that the community framework plan process will start. It would definitely start in 2021. And we welcome everyone to participate in that process in the community. We want to get as many voices as possible. So we look forward to working with all of you as we go forward on that plan.
No se tiene una fecha específica, pero se sabe que se debe de hacer durante el 2021 y se tendrá en comunicación a la comunidad para que sepa la fecha de inicio.
All right, well, thank you everyone who submitted questions tonight and prior to this meeting. That concludes the period of question and answers and I will pass the microphone back to Alicia.
Thank you, Sarah. Thank you, everyone. That is all the time we have today for questions and comments. Thank you for sharing your questions and comments. In addition to the recorded presentation, we will share a summary of tonight's meeting as well as a complete transcript of questions and comments received tonight on the project webpage next week. Finally, we invite you to submit additional questions or comments via email to park596@chicagoparkdistrict.com. And to keep in touch about the project, please be sure to fill out the virtual sign-in sheet. Ha llegado el tiempo para concluir la sesión. Gracias a todos por compartir sus preguntas y comentarios. La próxima semana en la página de internet estará disponible la grabación de esta presentación, un resumen de la junta de hoy y una lista de las preguntas y comentarios que se recibieron. Para concluir, los invitamos a mandar sus preguntas y comentarios adicionales al correo electrónico park596@chicagoparkdistrict.com. Nuevamente, les recuerdo que completen la forma virtual en el chat para mantenerse en contacto con el proyecto.
It has been a pleasure spending time with you today. We appreciate your participation, your comments, and your ideas. We are committed to this project and to seeing it built because we know it will make an incredible positive impact in the lives of the residents that live nearby. Thank you.
Ha sido un placer compartir este tiempo con ustedes. Agradecemos su participación, comentarios e ideas. Tenemos un gran compromiso con este proyecto, ya que sabemos que va a tener un impacto muy positivo en las vidas de los residentes de esta comunidad y sus alrededores. Gracias.